YouTube. It's your boy Banks coming at you with another health and fitness video that can hopefully help you hit your health and fitness goals. So today, got a video that I made, another circuit video. Like I said in the last video, you know, people have been making excuses saying they can't go to the gym and you can't work out because the gym is closed, or by the time I get home, I don't feel like changing and going back out to go to the gym, or it's too late to go to the gym, or whatever, whatever, blase, blase, whole bunch of bullshit. So, you ain't got no excuses no more, because I'm giving you these at-home workouts that you can do. You don't need no weights. All you need is your body and your motivation and your drive to be a better you. So with this one, is for the chest. And what I did was I implemented, you know, chest exercises that hit different angles of the pectoralis, major and minor muscles. So a lot of people don't realize that, you know, you can't just do, you know, one form of chest exercise and expect to get a defined chest. Like, you can't go to the gym and only do bench press on a flat bench and, you know, expect your whole chest to be swole up like Arnold Schwarzenegger or something like that. You have to hit the angle. Unless you like just having a wide flat chest, you know, then by all means, keep on doing your bench press, keep on hitting your max, trying to show off, saying you could do three plates, all this and that, but your chest still weak. You know, that's all what it boils down to. So this video, you know, you could do it real quick. I think it took me about 15 minutes total to do the whole thing. And let me tell you, just because it didn't take me long, that don't mean it ain't hit hard. I promise you, I got a pretty good workout out of this. I'm not going to say it was better than what I got at the gym, but it's pretty damn close. My chest was feeling it. It's going to work you out, I promise. So, without further ado, hope you like it. Here go the video.
All right, so the first exercise in this circuit is going to be the standard push-up. And this is going to work just your pectoralis, majors, muscle, and your triceps. So you're going to start off in a plank position, and then you're just going to lower your body in a straight line. Make sure your body is as straight as possible. Down, and then explode back up. Now, the second exercise, as you can see, is the incline push-up. Now, this also works your pectoralis muscles, but it focuses in on the lower portion of your pectoralis muscle group, as well as your triceps. And it's the same thing. You're going to get your arms at a comfortable distance on an elevated surface, and then you're going to basically simulate the same motion as you did with the standard push-up. The last variation of push-up we're gonna be doing, as you can see, was the decline push-up, which is pretty much the exact opposite of the incline push-up. Instead of having your hands on the elevated surface, you're gonna place your feet on the elevated surface, and this is gonna focus in on your upper chest muscles along with your anterior deltoids and your tricep muscles. Now, the last exercise we did in the circuit was the chest dip. Now, it's similar to the tricep dip. However, with the chest dip, you're gonna make sure your arms are widened out and you're gonna extend your chest forward as far as you can, and then lower your body to the ground and then come back up. You're gonna feel some stretching in your chest muscles, and because this particular exercise works the outer portion of your pectoralis muscle group. And for all of these exercises, you're gonna strive to get between 10 and 15 reps per exercise, and it's gonna be for 5 rounds. So 5 rounds and between 10 to 15 reps. So you could do 10 minimum. If you can get to 10, you all good. But 15 max.
There you have it, folks. Chest workout that you can do at your crib, at your house, at your office, whatever you want to do. Whatever you want to do. You ain't got to go to the gym. Just know that. You know, you just stop making that excuse saying you need to go to the gym in order for you to get a good workout, because that is false. You don't need the gym to get a good workout. You just need your body and your dedication, motivation, and your willingness to be a better version of yourself. Now, as I told y'all, that workout took a lot out of me. And, you know, like I said, you might be at your work, at your office or somewhere. You might be on your lunch break and you decide you want to do that workout. And I'm not going to lie, it's going to take a lot out of you. But you got to go back to work and you got other shit to do. So, quick little pick-me-up that you could use, and what I use, I drink these happy little babies right here. It's an energy drink from Amway. As you can see, it's zero sugar. And like I told y'all in the carbs video, sugar is like the number one carb. And you don't want too many sugars in your diet, because you only need a certain amount of carbs in your diet a day. And unfortunately, you can drink your carbs. So it's important that you try not to drink your carbs, which is why an energy drink like that is really good for you, because you're not going to be drinking a lot of carbs. You can save your carbs for your fibers and, you know, your vegetables and your fruits and things that you can really get other things from other than just sugar. You can get a lot of phytonutrients, which I will make a video about phytonutrients. But hit me up in the in my email, bankstomc@gmail.com. If you're interested in getting them, I'll get you what you need. So that's about it for this video. I hope you guys learned a lot. And thank you again for watching. Don't forget to comment, like, share, and subscribe. Or do all of them. I ain't gonna be mad if you do. Don't forget to tell a friend, tell that friend to tell a friend, and you need to come back at you next week with another video. Thank you, thank you, thank you.